Good afternoon, everybody. it's July 14th, Sunday, and I haven't been able to leave the edge of my yard since Wednesday. That was the last day I actually went out and did some shopping. And they've been assaulting me that intensively that I literally can barely move about the apartment. And so here I am still standing. I think I look remarkably well given the 6 or so hours of street torture I endured this morning. They really were targeting my right eye quite a lot. You can still see a little bit residual there of the rashing. And so I just wanted to give my 2 cents. I have studied philosophy, psychology while I was in college, and pretty much spent my entire adult life reading and studying the nature of consciousness, the brain, the human mind, reading many books, and you know, hopping on teleseminars, etc. And it's just remarkable to me, these boys have been attacking me like this for over 2 years. And they have these wall floor penetrating visual devices that they can see me as if I was walking around on a sheet of clear glass. And you know, and then all their assault toys. And they still have this Mobius loop thinking that if they just assault me some more with stronger weapons or greater poisons, that I will at last acquiesce and join their sex slave pedophile cabal. And so I just, every once in a while, I just kind of get inside their heads and just see not just the damage they're doing to me, although I remain completely unmolded, unbrainwashed, unacquiescing, as I was from the first moment they started attacking me. But meanwhile, you know, a young mind needs to get out in nature and interact with people and so forth. The human brain doesn't stop developing until early 20s. And if you do the same sort of repetitive task, you actually form physiologically in the brain synaptic pathways that are harder and harder to diverge from. And so if you're doing these behaviors that are really, you know, hate-centered, very narrow span of activity, any sort of televised exercise, anytime a brain is sitting in front of a screen and doing stuff remotely, there's very little brain activity going on. And so they're actually warping their brains, and subconsciously knowing that they're cowardly, you know, hiding behind a blind wall, so I don't even know who they are, and they have absolutely no accountability or responsibility. And they don't realize how that's just undermining their own sense of self-worth. It's like they're self-castrating. And, you know, reinforcing their fears of women, feeling threatened by women, that women that they have to act as a gang of boys with military weapons, treating a woman like an advancing army, even though she's defenseless and minding her own business in her own home and has, you know, nothing to do with them in the real world. And just from a Freudian perspective, I just call it, you know, you're not able to let go of the umbilical cord, because I'm old enough to be some of these guys' grandmother. And they have this fervent need to sexually molest and assault, as well as you know, attack any vulnerable area of my body. Someone old enough to be their grandmother, and think that they're going to gain some sort of power over me in any essential way. And the denial and the self-destructiveness, just reinforcing those fundamental tapes that they're incapable of interacting in a healthy way with women, that they can't function in a healthy way in the world, day-to-day world, as other people do. And they just want to stay at this infantile level in this fantasy, even though it's just causing them all this harm. So hopefully they'll get tired of being the laughing stock of planet Earth, because they all know that they're being observed in this behavior as well. And just hoping that they'll grow up before they kill me. All right, wish me luck.